Praetorian Guard, Howe, now turned on her, and in one of the most dramatic set-piece House of Commons speeches of modern times, plunged the dagger deep.
Sir Geoffrey Howe.
It's rather like sending your opening batsman to the crease, only for them to find, the moment the first balls are bowled, that their bats have been broken before the game by the team captain.
And my immediate thought was, that's done it.
The speech was an invitation to Michael Heseltine to stand against her. By doing so, he triggered the final act. Margaret Thatcher considered herself above parliamentary plotting. Rather than defending her position in Westminster, she went to Paris, to the summit that marked the end of the Cold War. Mrs. Thatcher had assumed that while she was signing the treaty to end the Cold War, a moment of personal triumph, her cabinet would be rallying support for her in Westminster. What was so hurtful for her to discover was that many of them had taken the opportunity of her absence to conspire against her. The following morning, she gave her resignation to her cabinet.
The door was open and we went in, and she'd quite clearly been crying. I mean, she was pink-eyed, and there was a box of tissues on the cabinet table, and a terrible air and, you know, solemnity. It was almost like a funeral.
In the cruel theatre of modern politics, exposed to millions on television, she departed from number 10.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're leaving Downing Street for the last time after 11 and a half wonderful years, and we're very happy that we leave the United Kingdom in a very, very much better state than when we came here 11 and a half years ago. Thank you very much. Goodbye.
I don't think she ever thought in her wildest nightmares that she would be booted out in the way she was by her own party. I think after she left number 10, her life crumbled. She lost the job she loved and wanted to keep. She lost her home, number 10. She lost her weekender, Checkers, and she had an empty diary. I mean, it was the most shattering blow anyone could ever have inflicted on her.
She was a tough act to follow. John Major had been alienated and suspicious of Mrs. Thatcher since she announced during his campaign that she would be a good backseat driver. Many blamed her for the disastrous showing of the party under John Major. She clearly hated the idea of going into retirement, and she'd never wanted to live in the house in Dulwich that she and Dennis had bought as an investment. Out of office, she wrote her memoirs and enjoyed great success on the lecture circuit, especially in the United States. She set up the Thatcher Foundation to uphold free market economics, but in reality became more and more a platform for her anti-Brussels views and took her into direct conflict with her successor, John Major. As the Conservative Party ripped itself in two over Europe, Tony Blair's New Labour inherited some of her legacy.
The young Tony Blair realised that Thatcherism actually was necessary. And I think it was that point, it was the conversion of Labour as much as the conversion of the Conservative Party, that was Thatcher's real legacy.
In 2007, when Lady Thatcher unveiled a new statue in the House of Commons, she demonstrated that she could still deliver a good one-liner.
The House has done me a great honour by commissioning this fine and imposing statue. I might have preferred iron, but bronze will do.
For David Cameron, the current leader of the Conservative Party, Margaret Thatcher's inheritance has been a mixed blessing.
It's a difficult legacy for the Conservative Party, because some people think that if you have a great leader, you just have to go on doing exactly what she would have done, as if the world hadn't changed, and obviously that's a mistake. David Cameron has had to do this thing in which he wishes to respect her legacy, learn from her, but also create a definite distance of identity, tone of voice, to some extent of ideas, for different times.
Because Margaret Thatcher had such a clear and almost pure approach and philosophy, that I think everyone is measured against that. In fact, when you go back and you look at Margaret Thatcher's time in a bit more detail, you can see that she was also pragmatic, that she was also, by times, cautious. She believed in preparing the ground before taking every step. So sometimes I think there can be a little bit too much mythology around the idea that everything Margaret Thatcher did was entirely in a straight line. Politics is never like that.
Like all great politicians, Margaret Thatcher's reputation will rise and fall with changing times. But one thing is certain. Her place will remain forever in the pantheon of Britain's greatest prime ministers.
Failure. Do you remember what Queen Victoria once said? Failure. The possibilities do not exist.
People of my generation will always measure other politicians against Margaret Thatcher. And I think her legacy is much greater than the politicians who went before her, stretching back into the 70s and 60s. And I think actually when the history books are written, I think the legacy of Thatcher will be much greater than the legacy of Blair or Brown, or dare I say, others.
The ladies not for turning.
One thing she had, greater quantity than anybody who worked with her, was she had willpower, she had courage, she was almost blind to danger, and she did have convictions.
All attempts to destroy democracy by terrorism will fail.
I believe that Margaret Thatcher is one of those very rare politicians, political leaders, who really does change things. I think she helped to make Britain governable again.
I'm enjoying this!
Because of what she managed to do in terms of the economy, because of what happened thousands of miles away in the South Atlantic, because of the democratization and control of the trade unions, because of the conquering of inflation, because of the change in tax rates, because of all these things, in the end, I think it is fair to say that she transformed Britain. She made us a stronger, prouder, greater country. And that is an incredible legacy for a politician to have.